las instrucciones de cómo vamos a estar trabajando. ¿Ok?
Que no se escucha, dicen acá.
Que no se escucha, chequéate a ver, sube el volumen a ti. No prendiste.
¿Qué hice? Artedis, ¿se escucha? Si quieren, es más fácil.
Entren al link.
Porque a lo mejor por aquí va a haber dificultad. Solamente lo tengo puesto para los que se pierdan, pues sepan cómo hacer. El link yo lo puse en el Facebook de la asociación abajo. Lo van a ver.
Guys, if you need help, just tell me. I'll share the link in Facebook again, okay?
Thank you, Marisa.
No need.
A todos los que ya están entrando, estamos esperando unos 5 minutitos más en lo que siguen entrando varios compañeros que estábamos en Facebook Live de la Asociación de Artistas Plásticos de Puerto Rico y se van a estar conectando vía Meet, que es la herramienta que estamos utilizando en estos momentos. Hola Fiorella, bienvenida. Marian, bienvenida. Bienvenida, Maricourt.
Gracias.
Omaris, bienvenida. Yarinel, bienvenida.
Yo parezco que tengo mi vida.
Esto lo tengo en su delante. let's start, okay, Francesca.
Yes, ready.
Bienvenidos a todos los presentes. Quiero darle las gracias por sintonizarnos aquí en esta grabación. Wait, I forgot my Facebook Live. Hola, bienvenidos a todos los presentes. Okay, bienvenidos a todos los presentes. Estamos aquí en una entrevista en vivo con la artista italiana Francesca Busca, una buena amiga que conocí hace unos cuantos años en Nueva York. La charla mayormente va a ser en inglés, pero ella entiende español. Okay. No se atreve a hablarlo, pero yo sé que si la empujamos, ella lo habla. Muy bien. Voy a indicarle brevemente las instrucciones que vamos a seguir para que no se nos haga, ¿verdad? Se nos desorganice la cosa. Todas las preguntas que vayamos a hacer a Francesca, apúntenla y las vamos a hacer al final para que no interrumpirla. Por favor, mantengan las cámaras y los micrófonos apagados. Cuando llegue a la sección de preguntas, cuando vaya a preguntar, pues prende su cámara y prende su micrófono para que salga en la grabación. Aquellos que no quieren ser grabados, por favor, pueden prender su micrófono, pero no prendan la cámara. ¿Ok? Vamos a pedir turno porque ya vemos unos cuantos, ¿verdad?, interactuando. Y nada, vamos a comenzar. Antes de comenzar con Francesca, yo quiero, yo consideré que una actividad muy buena, que yo la tenía programada para mi estudiante solamente, pero invité a mi amiga y colega artista, presidenta de la Asociación de Artistas Plásticos de Puerto Rico, la compañera Maricourt, y yo quiero que Maricourt nos dé una breve palabra.
Hola, estoy con mascarilla porque con lo de la pandemia, pues hay que estar así de esta forma, ¿verdad? Quiero darle los buenos días a todo el mundo, especialmente a Francesca Busca, por esta gran oportunidad, ¿verdad?, de compartir con ella. ¿Dónde es que está Francesca?
Ahora mismo está en Inglaterra.
Ahora mismo está en Inglaterra, pero ella es una artista italiana, según tengo entendido. Y ella pues hace sus obras, ¿verdad?, a través de utilizando basura, y hace unas tremendas obras que yo me he quedado perpleja. Yo le agradezco a Edwin Madurán por esta gran invitación. Yo creo que esta es una tremenda actividad. Vamos a conocer una excelente artista. Bienvenida, Francesca, y buenos días a todos.
Ok, pues aquí ya tenemos a mi amiguita y tremenda artista, Francesca Busca. Tenemos solamente 6 preguntas que hacerle. Y entonces dejar que ustedes sean los que lean todas las preguntas. Si quieren ver las obras de Francesca en Instagram, pueden entrar a Francesca_Busca y van a ver las preciosidades que ella hace. Francesca_Busca, lo voy a escribir aquí en el chat, ¿ok? Esa es la dirección de ella en Instagram, así es que mientras estamos charlando podemos ver los que están entrando. Saludo a Lourdes Román desde la ciudad de Nueva York. Hola. Ok, Francesca, Le voy a hacer las preguntas en español a Francesca. Sí. Y ella las tiene tanto en español como en inglés, así que no hay problema. ¿Desde cuándo te interesaste por el arte y en especial por el mosaico?
Yes, well, first of all, hello everyone. Thank you so much. I'm thrilled and flattered to be here. But anyway, so in answer to your questions, really, I was always interested in art. I think you just know, right? I think we're all artists inside. Someone just may see it as the most important thing or the thing that comes most natural to them. And I remember when I was as little as 6 or 7, I was selling my paintings on the street behind home. I did manage to sell a few for a few cents or something. Back then they were liras, so. But then with some misconception, I always saw work as something that had to be somehow hard or you had to work hard towards. And I just found art too much fun to be work. I just couldn't really see the two together. And quite frankly, at the end, I started to become a solicitor. I studied law to make up for my faults, the faults I found in my character, you know, the paying more attention to details rather than content perhaps. And so I ended up by being training as a city solicitor in London. And then after I had my children and I had to go back to work, I just thought, well, really, I think life is too short to go back to do something I didn't like. And I remember just in those years, I went to Aquileia with my children. I took them to Aquileia, which is a place in Italy, in Friuli, which is an ancient Roman site with a beautiful basilica, with some beautiful mosaics, which actually they keep discovering. There's more layers of them underneath. And I remember that I was enthusiastic about them. Hadn't been there for years, ever since I was little. And next to the basilica, there's a small shop where they sell little, you know, gifts. And they had these mosaics with pre-cut tiles that you could take home. And so I did. And since then, I think I was hooked. I spent 3 days just doing that, really. I even skipped meals, you know. So I just thought, wow, I really need to learn more about this. Next Aquileia, there's the next, not that far from it. There's the Scuola Mosaicista del Friuli in Spilimbergo, which is one of the most famous mosaic schools in the world, really. They did lots of works, you know, the Opera in Paris, the San Marco Basilica in Venice, just to mention a few. I mean, they're everywhere now. It's a beautiful school. So I went to see that too. And obviously, I live in London, so I was in Italy for the summer holidays. And as soon as I got back to London, I had to find a place where to study it, really. And I found Southbound Mosaics, because back then there wasn't really a school of mosaic in London. But ever since then, Southbound Mosaics became the London School of Mosaics. And then I graduated from it, and eventually I was asked to teach, to lecture the fabrication module as well. Which, you know, I'm thinking, I said yes to, obviously, because it's a beautiful opportunity, although there's huge shoes to fill from my own teacher, maestra, Giulia Vogridge, who comes from Spilimbergo originally. Anyway, that's just to sum up the story and how, you know, eventually, I think you're always brought back to what you should have done from the beginning, which should have been art, really. Definitely not law, but...
¿Y alguien cercano a ti o algún artista en particular ha influenciado en tu desarrollo artístico?
That's a very good question. But I think that, as for everyone, I think that we are really influenced by the great masters anyway, because, you know, we go to museums and that's what we see. And so I don't even think that you're consciously necessarily influenced by some of them, but you've got your favorite ones, and all of them teaches you something. And if anything, I think they teach you that art has an infinite number of ways in which it can be expressed and made, and infinite reasons to be, right? Whether it's intimate and it transmits your own feelings, or whether it's a message that you want to send, like, you know, provoke something in society, not only in individuals. And I think art is great for everyone anyway. You know, it's funny because I was reading an article the other day. They made a poll on what they thought was the most useful job and the less useful job. And actually art and an artist came up as the top useless job. And the second one was a telemarketer. So it's not even that. But anyway, you know, one can only laugh about it. I think it's essential for a society to progress, to express themselves, to just, you know, also to be open to changes and differences and understanding. I think it's essential. But anyway, that's obviously, I think we all feel the same in this.
That's the advantage of living in Europe, you know, everywhere you go is art.
Yes. But okay. Anyway, I have to say, sorry to finish it. At the end of the day, I think that also the artists are a great inspiration, obviously. And it's even better because you can talk to them and they can take you through their process. And, you know, when you get it going, you can discuss for hours. My own personal influence is really nature, I think, and the future of our ecosystem. And really also, you know, even looking at technology and architecture, the more they develop, the more they seem to revert to nature and, you know, its workings and its behaviors and its shapes and forms. And so, yeah, I think it's all around us. And that's what I drive a lot of inspiration from.
Yes. Okay. ¿Qué opinas del arte contemporáneo y cómo encajarías tu mosaico, tu obra, en estas tendencias o movimientos?
I would say that mosaics is more a technique than, you know, a movement or, I mean, I think it's preposterous that it's not considered a fine art to this day, because I think it possibly existed even before painting and drawing, you know, when you could, probably they were doing some environmental art, playing with pebbles, you know, and then finally found a way, an adhesive to make it stick, and started with real pebble mosaics in Pella, or, you know, in Greek and ancient Greek and Hellenistic times, and then moved on. But I think it's just a technique nowadays. I think it can fit wonderfully within contemporary art because it's just a 3D. It can be made with any 3D object, really. It's a composition. It can be abstract, figurative. And in my case, it can be done with rubbish. And we know we're floating in rubbish at the moment, right? The problem is that we don't know where to put it anymore because we produce so much. So really, for me, it's perfect. It fits wonderfully well in any movement.
¿Qué te hizo interesarte con la conservación del ambiente?
Well, I think that happened. My family has always been very eco-friendly and always tried to reduce their impact. Even back in the days when I remember we would go once a week or less even to the one recycling center we had in the whole, you know, council in the whole area, and we'll get everything in the car and go and drive to there, come back. It would be like the daily trip. But then, of course, being a solicitor, going through, you know, puberty first, and then the first years, I was a bit of a consumerist myself. I mean, quite a lot, you know, especially in the city, wearing high heels and, you know, fancy clothes and suits. But then after my children were born, really, I think I started seeing things differently again, because I'm thinking, what are we leaving them? That was also the time in which, obviously, we started realizing strongly what a huge problem it became, you know, our disposable lifestyle. And I think that's when I just made it my mission, really. I just thought, why can't I combine the two, you know, my two passions, meaning my children, their future, our future, really, and art.
Yes, so, that's, we have been in Puerto Rico pushing a lot about the conservation, because we have beautiful beaches, we have beautiful rivers, we have beautiful mountains, but people don't care, you know, they just throw the garbage anywhere, and we have been working on that really hard, you know. Okay, let's go for the other question. ¿Se te hizo difícil integrar los materiales reciclados a tu obra y comenzar a hacer arte con basura o rubbish art?
That's a good question, because I could say, yes, very difficult, and actually the easiest thing. Namely, the easiest thing is because, again, mosaic can really lend itself to any item. But it's just breaking that tradition, that idea that you have, you know, because obviously mosaic has its own rules. It has the andamentos, the tessera, they, you know, they need to follow certain rules. But at the same time, once you decide that you just move on and start using something else, yes, it becomes more difficult because obviously, you know, mosaic, you get the tiles or the marble, whatever it is, and you cut it, you know, to the way you, the shape you want it, and you do it. You, obviously, there's many other considerations to be taken into account, but with rubbish, what you have to do is find the materials that you think can be used, change it, shape it into something that can become a tessera. In my case, also something that's unrecognizable, you know, something that comes from ugly and rubbish to something beautiful, you know, like turning into a Cinderella. And also how to stick it on the board, because most plastic, for example, doesn't take to cement or glue. So sometimes I have to nail it or screw it in, you know, on the board to make it stay. Not to mention the collection, because I can't just go and buy rubbish. You would think I find it everywhere. Yes, but I've got to go and collect it. And sometimes I just look for certain items of rubbish. I mean, my cupboards are exploding with the rubbish I'm keeping there. And yet I still don't have enough for one piece, you know, because I need that kind of. And it takes me between 6 months and 1.5 years usually to gather enough material for one, say, 50 by 50 board, you know, piece. So it's. Yeah, it's more challenging, but I love it. And every single tessera, you know, tile that I managed to make is just a statement in its own. And yeah, so I'm liking it. But yes, it's again, it can be, mosaic is the perfect medium, but then again, it can be very, very hard, you know.
¿Cómo ha sido la aceptación del público en general con tu obra?
Well, I think we've got to, well, okay. So I think they're all very enthusiastic about the idea. Usually catches the eye of the viewer. And I love it also when they ask me what they're made with. And when I tell them where they come from, you know, they have their eyes widening, thinking, really? I could not have told, you know, from an Actimel bottle or whatever it is. So that's great. But I still think there's some prejudice from the private consumer, say, to about having, you know, rubbish in your house, no matter how clean it is.
They have it already, but not as an art piece.
Exactly. They're like, I've got enough already, thank you. No, but actually those people who do like it tend to come back for more. I mean, then they really get into it. And another thing is just be said for offices, because as you know, but not everyone might, I started this initiative a couple of years back, which is called Art for Trash, where I go into offices and I make artwork with their own rubbish. So it's more than just getting the artwork. It's about, you know, getting everyone into looking at the items they have in their hands differently, thinking, you know, what to me was disposable and I wouldn't even look twice at it before. Now it becomes an object that I have to look for and put on the side, because it'll be reused, it will have a second life. It's actually precious in its own way. So that has been extremely well received. I've done a few projects with some companies here in the City of London, Adobe. I actually started receiving interest from Milan, from Rome, even from New York, which I would have had to turn down anyway because it wouldn't have been eco-friendly, because all the projects that I do are virtually carbon zero emission. Zero emissions, sorry, carbon neutral, zero emissions. Because I go and get rubbish and bring the artwork back by public transport, for example. So definitely New York, I don't think I could have, you know, rowed a boat over. But anyway, and then COVID happened. And so everything is on hold because offices closed right away. But yet again, you see how in offices they would accept them, apparently. So...
Now you have to spray alcohol to everything.
Yes.
Alcohol, yes. You know, even to myself, that's part of what's happening worldwide. So no problem. Yes, okay, I will open now. So our friends, my students and friend, artist fellow, if they have some questions that they may ask you. Okay, ahora voy a abrir la sección para que le hagan cualquier pregunta a Francesca. Okay, y Marisa González ya está pidiendo un turno. Entra, Marisa, bienvenida.
Hello. Hi, Francesca. Es un placer conocerte. Forgive my English. I'm practicing it. So I'm interested in your art. It's really pretty. And I really want to know this pandemia have make an ha creado interés en ti para crear alguna pieza.
Oh, that's interesting. That's an interesting question. Actually, funnily enough, the problem with the pandemic is that first of all, we were closed indoors for a long time, and I couldn't go and gather material on the streets because I didn't trust doing it. I didn't think it would be nice. Already people look at me like I'm a weirdo when I, you know, lurk around trying to look rubbish on the street.
Yeah.
and with the pandemic, I didn't feel comfortable in doing that. But as you say, emotionally, it's funny because I actually put my rubbish art on hold and I started doing some recreation of painted artworks with things that you find at home. I don't know if you've seen some. It's the Getty Museum Challenge. And basically what you had to do, you had to recreate, you know, a famous artwork, I don't know, La Gioconda, for example, with things that you had at home. And I found it so much fun, and I would post it once every day. And I love seeing other people's as well. And I think it was great because at that point, I think it was more of a matter of lifting the mood, helping each other out in, you know, being hopeful and positive and also, you know, lifting the community spirit, really, and showing that we were there one for the other, for each other. So really, I devoted myself more to that than rubbish art. Though, mind you, I did have a couple of commissions to do, but I just couldn't gather the material to do them, so they were on hold. But I have been published by the Getty Museum as well, actually, in the book. There's four of my recreations there, too. So I was satisfying. But having said that, many museums actually did lots of little works on COVID and, you know, the germs, and some very interesting works came out from the mosaic world during that period. I was quite impressed.
That will be awesome. Thank you a lot, and hugs from Puerto Rico.
Thank you.
Muy bien, gracias Marisa. ¿Alguien más tiene alguna pregunta para Francesca? Debo decir que en mi Facebook Live está Cristina desde Isla Canaria en España. Es una buena reportera y buena amiga. Ok, ¿alguna otra pregunta de parte de los presentes y de acá en Facebook Live? ¿Alguna pregunta a Francesca? Ok, yo le voy entonces a hacer una pregunta, Francesca. I will do to you a question. When I met you in New York in the exhibit in New York about 4 years already, something like that, right? It was the New York Art Expo. You wasn't doing the rubbish art.
No. Yeah, I just started so back then. Remember, I would incorporate a few. Yeah, we met when I just started with a few things here and there. I think it was more of a test, even for myself as well. And it's funny because that brings me to saying something else. When I was little, for example, I loved colors. So I would try the impossible task of fitting all colors, you know, into one drawing. And I remember with mosaics as well, I've always loved colors. And now that I'm doing rubbish, yes, if I use metal, for example, you find some incredible colors, you know, very shiny. I mean, it's a pleasure to me. That's my treasure, really. You know, it's like using smalti or gold for a mosaicist. But then when you use plastic, yes, you can find some, but it's very hard to fit them all together. So I tend to use, you know, monochrome, just one color. Mm-hmm. And that is quite a challenge, actually, for me, to undertake. And I think that this is when the real difference happened. You know, when you met me, I was still multicolored. And
yeah. But if you come to visit us, to our island, these are our colors, you know, very bright colors. Mm-hmm. And you will find a lot of junk around with a lot of beautiful colors.
love the gap.
Marie has a question for you.
Yes.
Hola.
Hola.
Mi pregunta es la siguiente. En ese proceso de tú hacer la obra, ¿verdad? Per se, ¿cómo es que tú haces la obra? ¿Tú vas eligiendo, ok, ya tú tienes la obra en la mente, o cuando tú vas coleccionando esas, el garbage, ¿cómo es?
Basura.
El material, ahí es que tú comienzas a hacer lo creativo de la obra, o ya tú tienes, antes de tu coleccionar, vas buscando, o sea, ¿cuál es el proceso? Si lo que tú tienes en mente lo vas buscando, o lo que tú recoges, tú creas.
That's a very good question, because actually I had to change it completely, my method, because I used to start from the idea and then I will develop it starting from the idea, right? Start from the concept, then you go on to, you know, the actual project, whether it's figurative, abstract, whatever, how you want to express it, and then you choose the material. That's how I used to work before, and that's how a mosaicist usually works. But with this, it's actually material driven. So I had to start looking around, looking at everything with different eyes, thinking, okay, what can this become? Do you know, how can I work this out to make it beautiful, really, because that's a provocation, right? To make rubbish beautiful. And so now I usually start from the material and then I decide what to do. Of course, you already have some ideas of how you would like it to be. But yes, it's a very good question. I had to change it completely, you know, opposites to extremes. And I love it this way as well, but it requires a lot of patience, which I didn't used to have either. Now, you know, you have to. So, yes.
Cuando yo vi tu obra, me quedé sumamente impresionada de la manera de que, cómo tú utilizas la basura, ¿verdad? Y la convierte en algo bello, que ante los ojos de otra persona, dije, eso es basura, se cuestiona. Pero muy bien, de verdad que te felicito muchísimo.
Thank you, Michael. If I can say one thing, sorry, because I need to spread and convert people, really. I don't mind at all if people start doing what I do. I think I'm the first artist who would actually like to be out of a job soon, which will mean, you know, we don't have any more waste lying around and it's all used for a better purpose. So please do bear in mind that everything we do has an impact. And recycling, in, waste is one of the main problems that we have at the moment, and recycling is not the way forward, because many people don't know, for example, that plastic or paper can only be recycled up to 2-3 times tops. Plastic, most of, even the plastic they say it's recyclable, most of the time is not recycled anyway, because they don't have the right plant, the right, you know, structure to do that. And even so, what is recycled most of the time is actually contaminated, because people throw away, well, put things in the recycling bin which shouldn't be put there, and then the machine or the people that manually select them let some, you know, pass through. That just happens. In which case, the whole lot that has been recycled so far has to be thrown away again. So we need to be better. We need to reduce. Yes, of course, people are looking at other, you know, solutions. But in the meantime, we need to stop living a disposable lifestyle. I know it's hard. It's so hard for myself too. Every day I learn something new, and I think, how could I make this better? Because I still, you know, it's hard to break the habits. But I really think we should, because we reached the point of almost no return, really. Mm-hmm. We need to, you know, whatever we do, even as artists, especially as artists, because we should be leading the changes. We should be provoking people. We're the ones who should be thinking alternatively, you know, in a different way. We are the ones, I think, who need to, you know, can really make an impact on it. So please, by all means, you know, think about it. Everything you do, think about it.
I have been teaching for almost 50 years. And since the beginning, I noticed that we didn't have enough materials. So I started working with recycled materials. So now that I am in at the University of Puerto Rico, I encourage my students to use the recycled materials. So when I saw your work, I said, this is the opportunity for me and for Francesca to talk about recycling, the importance in our world is not only about community, it's the whole world. I just posted a video of the importance that we have to look out for our world, because all the changes that we have on the climate, you can see what happened in Texas. Yeah. The houses wasn't prepared to have the load of snow.
Yeah. You mentioned what happened to you just, you know, not so long ago. I mean, the disaster you had to.
Yeah. Okay, Marie wants to.
Pues mira, me uno a las palabras de Edwin Mauraz, porque precisamente eso era lo que quería decir. Ojalá que existan más artistas, ¿verdad?, que hagan estas clases de trabajo. Y así ayudamos a ecosistemas mundialmente, porque ahora mismo es necesario. Nada, gracias, Francesca. Gracias por tu trabajo, de verdad que es un trabajo excelente. Y sigue ayudando al ecosistema, como lo haces.
Bien. ¿Alguien más tiene alguna pregunta? Marisa tiene una pregunta. Prende la cámara para que...
Es que no creo que me vea muy bien ahora mismo.
Dios mío.
Ok, pero voy a prenderla, pero ay, Dios mío.
Usted es bella como quiera.
Gracias.
Saludos a Julio, okay. Saludos a Mirna Rivero, las quiero mucho. Ahí está Marisa.
Ok, hola. Bueno. Pues la verdad es que estoy encantada con toda la entrevista, realmente la información es excelente y you're blowing my mind de una manera tan especial, porque pues yo no soy artista, ¿verdad?, pintora, yo no soy de dibujar, pero me encanta, me fascinan todas las artes, pero sí soy actriz en formación y pues, pues he creado piezas. Entonces, una de las cosas que me llama la atención y que me has inspirado en este momento también, hablando ahora de lo que es cuidar el medio ambiente, es que para la utilización de la creación de la escenografía, podemos también, los que estamos trabajando en teatro, utilizar todo lo que es reciclable.
Sí, sí, absolutamente, absolutamente. Yes, it's wonderful. I think it's actually the perfect setting to do that. Perfect. Also because I love theater myself, and I realize that most of the times it's your imagination that will make the scenery behind. You know, sometimes you don't even need to recreate. You will know more than I do, but you don't need to recreate the object, but just give the idea of what that object is. Or, and I mean, the things you can do. I don't know if you saw, God, I don't remember the name. It's a couple of artists who actually create these sculptures in which the figure is created by the shadow. So basically, you know, they project a light onto this sculpture that they make, and the shadow at the back is incredible. And if you look at the sculpture itself, you would never be able to tell, right, that that's what they made. That's another idea, you know, that you could, oh, please, by all means, that would be excellent if you could. You could even ask, you know, for the community to contribute beforehand, you know, put out an open call for rubbish to be collected or things that you're looking for, a certain color, for example, you know, that's what I do with my friends. I put a call out like, excuse me, please, I need, you know, does anyone have any? And I think we need to stop thinking always professionally, always thinking, oh, the neatest, the best, the most professional, the cutting edge things. No, I think if we want to survive this huge crisis we're getting into, we need to think community. We need to think, let's help each other. Let's do things that are good for us, for everyone, for the environment. Let's help each other out. Appreciate, you know, what can be done with minimum waste. You know, with minimum creation of pollution, really. And let's help each other. Let's have fun together. Everything, you know, we only live once, for God's sake. And we work most of the day anyway, most of the year, you know, to have enough to maintain ourselves and our family. At least it should be fun, shouldn't it? For as much as possible. And we should be able to laugh about it. Sorry, that's I got caught in a run there, but I think your idea is brilliant.
Antes tenga alguna pregunta, Francesca, vamos a aprovecharla. Ella está lejos, ella está en Inglaterra.
Gracias y muy de acuerdo con usted en todo. Así que, como ya estaban diciendo los compañeros y mi querido profesor Eddie, gracias por lo que estás haciendo, por tu aporte. Es muy importante, así que vamos todos a implementarlo, ¿verdad? De alguna forma u otra, en lo que sea, en lo que amemos. Así que, adelante.
Sorry to interrupt, but if you have any questions on ideas on how to stick materials together or other things, please contact me. I'd love to help.
For oh my God, thank you.
I have so far.
Thank you. I'll do it.
¿Alguna otra pregunta, por favor? Okay, no hay más ninguna pregunta, pues vamos a despedirnos, Francesca, porque ya hemos estado cerca de 40 y algo minutos hablando, y eso es bueno. No es bueno cansar a la audiencia, sino dejarlo con hambre. I was laughing because it's a subway. I did talk about getting hungry, but not about any commercial here. There's no commercial here. So
you're hungry, Eddie.
I'm always hungry. Okay. Please, if you have anything to say to our fellow artists and to my students, please do it.
Well, I'll be saying the same things you tell them, but not going against your word. We should have talked about this earlier. That's a tricky question. But just be yourself. Be yourself. Do the things that you think are right. Not what you think other people will like or would want to see. Don't believe that everything has been done already, because it hasn't. It really hasn't. and just trust yourself, be true, enjoy what you're doing, and please again, think about the impact of everything you do, and try to reduce it, prevent it, ideally, but you know, then you wouldn't be making art, and that is essential.
Okay, so, yeah. I want to tell Marie Kurt, the president of our Artists Association, Puerto Rican Artists Association, to say goodbye to you and to all the my students and all the fellow artists.
Thank you.
Bueno, Francesca, gracias por esta gran oportunidad nuevamente, por compartir de tu tiempo con nosotros, ¿verdad? También me quiero despedir de todos los estudiantes de la UPR de Bellas Artes, y exhortarlos a que, ¿verdad?, en algún momento se unan a la Asociación de Artistas Plásticos de Puerto Rico. Es bueno para ustedes, ¿verdad?, que aquellos que estén comenzando puedan comenzar a poder exponer poco a poco y llenar su currículum. Gracias a todos. Un besito a todos, y que Dios me los bendiga.
Yo voy a poner ahora a Marie Kurt en camisa de once varas, ¿ok? Porque hace muchas lunas atrás, hace muchos años, nosotros hicimos un capítulo de estudiantes de educación bajo la Asociación de Maestros de Puerto Rico. Ahora yo le tiro esa a Marie, nuestra presidenta. ¿Por qué no hacemos un capítulo de estudiantes de Bellas Artes bajo, y así se van preparando para cuando se hagan profesional? Así que le dejo esa bolita a Marie Kurt y a la Junta, que yo sé que hay dos o tres de la Junta por ahí viéndonos.
De hecho, déjame decirte que desde que tienen 18 años en adelante pueden integrarse a la Asociación de Artistas Plásticos de Puerto Rico.
Muy bien, así que ya tienen ahí todos mis estudiantes de la Universidad de Puerto Rico, son ya sobre 18 años. Así que de todas maneras, pues, pueden ya ser partícipe de la asociación. Y si nos formamos bajo un capítulo, pues mejor.
Mucho mejor.
Ok. Gracias, Francesca. Love you.
Thank you, Edwin. Thank you, Marie Kurt. It was a pleasure. Thank you so much.
We will keep in touch. Ok. I have good news to tell you, but later I can't say it here because I don't have proof yet. When they write me the proof, I will publish and I will say the good news. Love you, love you, love you. Say hello to your kids and for your puppy that keep on helping you in the...
Yes, yes, he's essential.
We love you, see you. Gracias a todos por estar con nosotros. Le agradecemos mucho, mucho, mucho. Bye-bye.